A huge honor for the former leader of Milwaukee's Catholic Church.
His Eminence, Timothy Cardinal Dolan. Doesn't that sound great?
Now at 5, the new duties Timothy Dolan will carry out as a cardinal, plus how family members and parishioners in Milwaukee are reacting to the news. Good evening, I'm Toya Washington.
And I'm Terry Sater, in for Kathy tonight. The public announcement of Archbishop Dolan's new title came during Mass in New York City this morning.
Pope Benedict XVI named to the College of Cardinals our Archbishop Timothy Dolan.
Dolan is one of 22 archbishops elevated today. The list includes just one other American, Edward O'Brien, who's the former Archbishop of Baltimore. Dolan will remain in New York City, but as a cardinal, he will have more decision-making responsibilities in Rome. The archbishop says he's both honored and humbled by the appointment.
Whoever had this position would be named a cardinal because it's a mark of respect for the great Archdiocese of New York. It's almost as if Pope Benedict XVI is putting the red hat of the cardinal on top of the Empire State Building or upon the Statue of Liberty.
And Dolan was the Archbishop of Milwaukee for 7 years before being promoted to New York.
12 News' Mike Anderson joins us from the Cathedral of St. John. And Mike, Catholics are pretty excited about this.
Well, back in 2002, Archbishop Dolan was installed here at the Cathedral of St. John in downtown Milwaukee, and Catholics here tonight feel they have a private, personal relationship with someone who is now in a higher place.
His Eminence, Timothy Cardinal Dolan. Doesn't that sound great?
New York Archbishop Timothy Dolan says he views the Vatican's decision to name him a cardinal as a call to higher service. Here in Milwaukee, the man who succeeded Dolan as Archbishop, Jerome Listecki, says he's not surprised that Dolan is moving on up, and this community feels very much a part of it.
We're a piece of Archbishop Dolan. And, you know, we helped in the formation of him, both as a leader, Archbishop here in Milwaukee, and continue on with our support of him as he is Archbishop of New York. So with that, you know, that piece of us is elevated also.
The 61-year-old Dolan will have more decision-making responsibilities in Rome, but will continue to work as Archbishop of New York. Cardinals are the Pope's key advisors and are members of the group that will eventually elect the next Pope. 12 News asked Archbishop Dolan's brother Bob, who still lives in Milwaukee, what about the whispers he's hearing about his brother possibly becoming the first American Pope?
We keep hearing that. And it's amazing how many people, Mike, when I see people out, they'll say, you know, your brother, one day he could. And I just don't go there. He doesn't go there. I mean, the one thing, if you ever want to get him angry or uncomfortable, go there, because he doesn't like that. He doesn't like that talk.
Dolan says his brother is a very humble man. That's why the people of Milwaukee were so drawn to him. Peter Isley of the Survivors Network of Those Abused by Priests says Dolan left unfinished business in Milwaukee, particularly questions that still remain about the sex abuse crisis and its financial fallout.
And the bankruptcy is unfortunately kind of the legacy that he left. Now, he's left other things, of course, that he should be, you know, that people praise him for, but this bankruptcy is really changing the entire course of this archdiocese.
There is still expected to be court action in those cases, and Dolan has acknowledged in the past the sex abuse and bankruptcy were among his most challenging times. Dolan will be elevated in Rome next month, and current Archbishop of Milwaukee Listecki says he will be there, as well as his brother, Bob Dolan. Live in Milwaukee at the Cathedral of St. John, Mike Anderson, WISN 12 News.
Thank you, Mike. And many parishioners in New York say they are overjoyed with Dolan's new title.
Dolan was installed as Archbishop of New York in April of 2009. Since then, residents say he has made an impact on their city with his humility and his common man approach.
I think he's reached out to people. I think that, you know, there's always a divide. People have favorites, but he really is exceptionally warm, and he's made an impact, I think, everywhere he's gone.
It's probably good for New York. It's good for the Catholic Church here, and that can only be good for the church worldwide.
I said to my sister, I ran upstairs, I said, guess what? The Archbishop is a cardinal now. He's Eminence.
Dolan is also president of the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops.
Timothy Dolan was born in St. Louis in 1950, and just 14 years later, he began his path to spiritual leadership when he entered a seminary.
Cardinal Dolan was ordained a priest in 1976 and studied for his doctorate at Catholic University in Washington. He went on to further his studies in Rome and was a rector at the Pontifical North American College. In 2001, Pope John Paul II appointed Dolan Auxiliary Bishop of St. Louis. 1 year later, in 2002, he was named Archbishop of Milwaukee. He lived in the Badger State for 7 years, and in 2009, Pope Benedict XVI appointed Dolan the 10th Archbishop of New York.
Well, and here's a recap of our top story tonight. Former Milwaukee Archbishop Timothy Dolan is now a cardinal. He learned of the Pope's decision to elevate him and 21 other archbishops yesterday. Cardinals are the Pope's key advisors and are members of a group that will eventually elect the next Pope. Now, including the newly elected cardinals, there are only 125 who are eligible to elect someone to the position of Pope. Pope Benedict will hold a former elevation ceremony on February 18th.